July 7th, 2016. Yong Wei, Mark and I decided to head out on a mini-adventure to Pulau Ubin. We've all been pretty busy with our own lives and have hardly had time to meet up, so this was the perfect getaway to just chill and reminisce the good times like in high school.
Hi friends, so we just reached Pulau Ubin and now we are about to rent some bikes so that we can traverse the island in speed and style.
We rented our rickety bicycles and began exploring the island.
We're just climbing up to the top of Puaka Hill. We have decided to bring all our bags and stuff with us because we don't want them to get lost. So it's pretty tiring.
It had rained earlier in the morning, but there's no sign of it. The sky was clear blue with puffy white clouds. There is a gentle breeze every now and then. No sound of cars honking or the drilling from the construction sites. Only the screeching of the cicadas and the chirping of the birds. Time seemed to slow down. It felt so peaceful.
One. Don't throw your camera. Maybe it's a bit too high still.
Yeah.
We roamed around a little more, tried to set up a hammock, and watched Yong Wei land spectacularly on his butt. Okay, I shouldn't have laughed, but then again, what are friends for? Soon after, we cycled back to the jetty for some cold drinks and fresh coconut juice. This is also where Yong Wei shared some exciting stories from his recent trip to Machu Picchu in Peru, while I daydreamed about visiting South America myself someday. It was starting to get late, so we headed off for a campsite on the other side of the island. First thing on the list was to pitch our tent.
The camping lads working hard?
Yeah.
While I do nothing?
Yep.
Alright, so we're setting up tent over here after like 30 minutes of trying.
So, we managed to successfully set up the tent as it was designed, thanks to my keen eye. Unfortunately, we had to pack it back up because of the culprit sitting there. Which is not really the monkey's fault. Wow. It's more because the tent can't be zipped up. So, just
that's
to
my
not
fault.
Take any chances, yeah. We're gonna move to a place where there'll be zero intruders.
In the end, we decided not to go to another campsite. Instead, we moved our tent away from the trees and more into the open. This gave us some extra time to explore the surroundings before it got dark.
As the sun slowly set, we went around to prepare for a fire and to cook dinner. Not having a stove with adjustable flames or much cooking supplies made for a very interesting cooking experience. Curry Maggi, chicken sausages, and sardines were all we had on the Ubin menu, and we waited for the fire to boil the water and warm the sausages.
Oh, that looks good, bruh.
Smells good too.
Smells good.
I think can.
Maybe we were very hungry, or it was the novelty of camping outside, but the noodles tasted delicious and we devoured them instantly. Once the solid fuel died out, knowing how to properly stoke and build up a fire took a lot more effort and care. As we went around searching for more fuel and continued to maintain the fire, it felt nice to just be part of nature and not do anything in particular. We enjoyed moments of peace and quiet with the crackling of the fire and the distant sounds of waves and insects as our background music. We decided that it was time to turn in to wake up early for sunrise tomorrow. That was a plan that never actually happened. All the wind in that area somehow managed to come to a standstill for the entire night, and we soon admitted defeat after the tent turned out to be too hot to be inhabited by human beings. Then began the valiant effort to stay awake all the way until 5 a.m. and our conversation suddenly took a very philosophical and deep turn. We talked about freedom, gun laws, religion, and all that intellectual stuff I guess you wouldn't associate us with. Sunrise came not at 5 o'clock, but at 6:40 to 7 o'clock, and it was blocked by this magnificent sheet of clouds that stretched all the way across the horizon.
Good morning, boys. How's it going?
It's good, it's good. Feeling like $1 million.
Had a good sleep last night?
Like 50 cents. What sleep?
I guess that was it. The end of an amazing journey, and definitely one that will be remembered for a long, long time.